Who is Jose Rizal?
Jose Protasio Rizal Mercado y Alonso Rialonda, or Pepe for short.
He is also known as Dimasalang and Laong Laan in his writings.
Jose Rizal's two famous novels are Nolime Tangere that talks about the social cancer, and the second one is the El Filibusterismo that emphasizes on the reign of greed.
Jose Rizal was born June 19, 1861,
at the town of Calamba, province of Laguna.
He was the seventh child of Francisco Mercado and Teodora Alonso.
Jose Rizal had nine sisters and one brother, namely Saturnina, Pasiano, Narcisa, Olimpia, Lucia, Maria, Concepcion, Josefa, Trinidad, and the youngest is Soledad.
But did you know that Concepcion died at the age of 3? In those days are the sorrowful days of Rizal, murmuring to the death of his sister.
And now let us proceed to the women of Jose Rizal, the Sanaol edition.
The following girls was linked with Rizal. The first one is Segunda Katigbak, his teenage puppy love. And then followed by Leonor Valenzuela, his imagined love. Why imagined love? Because it said that it was a love story made by his gossip friend Jose Cecilio.
Jose Rizal's third love was Leonor Rivera. Their love story is a long-distance idealized but doomed love. Jose Rizal was in love with Leonor Rivera. He even invented a coded alphabet so that they could write sweet nothings to each other. But Leonor Rivera faded in the memory of Rizal because in Europe, Rizal conveniently romanced other girls and forgot he was engaged. And the sad part is, Rivera-Rizal engagement did not survive the long-distance romance. In the end, it turned into an idealized one.
Consuelo Ortega was the fourth love of Jose Rizal, the daughter of Don Pablo Ortega. Consuelo fell in love with Rizal, but Rizal backed out before the relationship turned into serious romance, to the fact that Rizal wanted to stay loyal to Leonor Rivera and did not want to destroy his friendship with Eduardo de Lete, who was madly in love with Consuelo.
The next one is Ossie-san, the fifth love of Jose Rizal, the Japanese samurai's daughter. She taught Jose Rizal's Japanese art of painting, known as Sumi. Gertrude Beckett was the sixth love of Jose Rizal, a blue-eyed and buxom girl, the oldest of the three Beckett's daughter. And the seventh love of Jose Rizal was Nellie Bausted. Rizal and Nellie's love affair unfortunately did not end in marriage. It failed because Jose Rizal refused to be converted to the Protestant faith, as Nellie demanded and Nellie's mother did not like a physician without enough paying clientele to be a son-in-law. And the next one is Zane Jacobe. In 1890, Jose Rizal moved to Brussels because of the high cost of living in Paris. He lived in the boarding house of two Jacobe sisters. In time, they fell in love with each other, but just like what happens to the previous girls, Rizal and Susanne part ways after Rizal left Brussels. And the last one is Josephine Bracken. In the last day of February 1895, while still in the Pitan, Jose Rizal met an 18-year-old petite Irish girl with bold eyes, brown hair, and a happy disposition. It was Josephine Bracken, the adopted daughter of George Stauffer from Hong Kong. They came to the Pitan to seek Rizal for eye treatment. And finally, Jose Rizal married Josephine Bracken, but it is still a debate whether these two got married. So let us proceed to the education of Jose Rizal. Jose Rizal early education in Calamba and Binyan. At the age of 3, Jose Rizal learned English alphabet from his mother, and by the age of 5, he could already read and write. Jose Rizal also showed inclination to be an artist. He outstanded his family and relatives by his pencil drawings and sketches and by moldings of clay. Rizal's parents employed private tutors to give him lessons at home. First tutor was Maestro Celestino, and the second one is Maestro Lucas Padua. Later, an old man named Leon Monroy, a former classmate of his father, became his tutor. Unfortunately, Monroy died 5 months later. After Monroy's death, Rizal's parents decided to send him to a private school in Binyan. Jose Rizal, at the age of 16,
get his Bachelor of Arts degree in Ateneo Municipal de Manila. He graduated as one of the 9 students declared sobresaliente. He further continued his education to obtain a degree in land surveying and assessor. In University of Santo Tomas, he studied philosophy and letters during his first year and then soon shifted to medicine, specializing in ophthalmology when he found out that his mother was going blind. But he was disappointed at a Dominican institution of higher learning because of the following. First, the Dominican professors were hostile to him. Second, the Filipino students were racially discriminated against by the Spaniards. And the last one is the method of instruction was obsolete and repressive. After finishing the fourth year of his medical course, he could no longer endure the discrimination, rampant bigotry, and the hostility in the University of Santo Tomas and decided to study in Spain. In May 1882, Rizal went to Madrid to continue his studies in medicine at the Universidad Central de Madrid. In 1884, he obtained a degree of licentiate in medicine and degree of philosophy and letters in 1885. It was in Spain where Jose Rizal realizes his dream. His vision broadened to the point of awakening in him an understanding of human nature, sparking in him the realization that his people need him. So, he decided to write a novel. His first novel was Noli Me Tangere. He wrote half of the novel in Madrid, a quarter in Paris, and the rest are in Germany. It was in Europe where he earned his second doctorate. And in the University of Heidelberg, he completed his eye specialization under the renowned professor Otto Becker in 1887 at the age of 25. Then, Jose Rizal stayed in Europe for 10 years. In 1992, Jose Rizal returned to the Philippines and formed La Liga Filipina, a non-violent reform society of patriotic citizens and a forum for Filipinos to express their hopes for reform, to promote progress through commerce, industry and agriculture, and freedom from the oppressive Spanish colonial administration. On July 6, 1892, he was imprisoned in Fort Santiago on the charge of instigating unrest against Spain. He was exiled to Dapitan in northwestern Mindanao. He remained in exile for 4 years. While Rizal was in political exile in Dapitan, he practiced medicine, he established a school for boys, promoted community development projects. Jose Rizal also applied his knowledge in engineering by constructing a system of waterworks in order to forest clean water to the town's people. In 1896, the Katipunan launched a revolt against the Spaniards. Although Jose Rizal had no connection with the organization, his enemies were able to link him with the revolt. To avoid being involved in the move to start a revolution, Rizal asked Governor Ramon Blanco to send him to Cuba. Unfortunately, he was brought back to Manila and jailed for the second time at Fort Santiago. On 26 of December 1896, after a trial, Jose Rizal was sentenced to death. He was convicted of rebellion, sedition, and forming of illegal association. On the eve of his execution, while confined in Fort Santiago, Rizal wrote a poem, Mi Ultimo Adios, My Last Farewell, and hid inside the gas burner and gave the gas burner to his sister Trinidad and his wife, Josephine. Rizal was executed on December 30, 1896 at the age of 35 by a firing squad at Bagumbayan and now known as the Luneta Park in Manila. And for the realization, Jose Rizal taught me 4 things. Number 1 is
creativity. We should be creative enough people to function effectively in the society. What do I mean? Just like Jose Rizal, we should maximize our talents and potential to formulate substantial ideas that we can use efficiently. For example, Jose Rizal. He is creative enough to impact people's decision and alter their beliefs towards Spaniards. But, as you can realize, his chosen strategies abide his talent. So, to point out my idea, what I really mean is, let us improve our strength, focus on our capacity, and use it to influence people or use it to make ourselves better.
The second one is bravery. In every actions, there is a corresponding consequences. And I know that we all aware about this. So before you make a movement or a decision, you should have the courage that whatever the consequences is, you are ready to face it. The third one is be smart. I really love how Jose Rizal abandoned Philippines and traveled abroad to find his best self. And for us, the youth of this country, the hope of the nation according to Rizal, we should not be afraid to leave a place that does not complement us. I mean, if you do not see yourself progressing in that place, you should leave. Don't stop seeking for greatness, even if you travel out of your comfort zone. We should not be a frog that is contented on a small pond. The world is big. We should sail the sea to find our purpose and to unlock our full potential and talent.
And lastly, I realized the importance of education. Just like Jose Rizal, if you have a degree, people will look up to you. But it does not mean that you will look down to them. Education is our passport to success. And we should embrace it. Give time, effort, and love. Always remember, right education can lead you to your dreams as long as it is not exploited.
Hello everyone, so that's all for today. I hope that you have learned, enjoy, and appreciate my simple presentation. And thank you for listening.